This tutorial shows how to conduct the one-way ANOVA in R and interpret its results. Its purpose is testing three or more groups for differences in their means. For example, I have a group variable depicting whether the person has no degree, a bachelor's, or a master's degree. I use the one-way ANOVA to test for a difference in the average income between those three groups. The requirements for the one-way ANOVA are the following: three or more independent groups, a dependent variable on the interval or ratio scale, normally distributed residuals, and homogeneous variances across groups. The latter two are shown in separate videos to keep this one as concise as possible. As a first step, I want to see some descriptive statistics to get a first idea of my data. I recommend the psych-package for that and its describe by function. Please note that it is advised to have the group variable as a factor. Put the test variable first and then add the group variable separated by a comma. I can see that the mean is higher for a higher degree. I also tend to have unequal variances, which are ignored for the purpose of showing you the basic ANOVA calculation. You can also visualize the three groups by using box plots and seeing the interquartile range represented by the height of the box and the median by the black horizontal lines respectively. The circled cases have the 1.5 times interquartile range distance to the edges of the box and are sometimes referred to as outliers. Now I want to test whether the means are significantly different from each other. I use the ANOVA underscore test function of the rstatix package. I start off with the test variable, the income. After that I use tilde, the small wave symbol, and put the group variable, the degree, behind it. When I run this line I get the results. If the p-value is below the predefined threshold, for example 0.05, the null hypothesis can be rejected. Reminder, the null hypothesis for the one-way ANOVA assumes no difference of the means between the tested groups. In my case, I defined alpha as 0.05 and can therefore reject the null hypothesis because my p-value is very small with 0.00805. I can therefore conclude that the means are different. After a significant one-way ANOVA, post-hoc tests should be calculated. An effect size for the one-way ANOVA itself is optional. The two videos shown now will show you how to do both.